Yeah.
Ma'am, can I start?
Yeah, you can start. Already she showed you, no? Okay.
Yeah. Ma'am, can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear. Narendra, okay. When you want to change the slide, you tell Anubhama to change the slide. Okay.
Okay.
Then only she will come to know. Okay, fine. Continue.
Today I am going to present a seminar of lesson 7, types of plants. Ma'am, can you plants definition and role. Plants are multi cellular cellular organisms. They play an important role in supporting life in our planet. By providing oxygen, they make their own food by a process called photosynthesis. Can I change? Classification of plants. The plant kingdom has been classified into three: trees, shrubs, herbs, grass. Edible parts of plants. Not all plants of any given plants are edible, but all parts of edible plants have been known to figure as raw or cooked food. Leaves, roots, shrubs, stems, seeds, buds, fruits, and flowers. Can I change?
Next slide. That's all?
Yes, ma'am. This is the last slide.
Okay. Okay, now you can stop sharing and you can ask some questions to your friends, Narendra.
Okay, ma'am.
Maybe example of shrubs or trees or whatever it is.
Ma'am, can I ask to Irene?
Okay, Irene, the question is asking by Narendra. Yeah.
What is photosynthesis?
Irene, can you hear what Narendran said? What is photosynthesis? Can you give the answer?
Can I, Narendran?
Irene, give the answer, Irene.
Ma'am, can I say?
I think she's not able to hear. Okay,
Amma, so I will give the question to Narin.
Narin.
The process in which plants make their own food is known as photosynthesis.
Okay,
yes,
good.
Yes, ma'am, it's the right answer.
Okay, one more question.
Okay, ma'am, next I will answer to ma'am, Amna.
Amna, next question.
Example of shrubs.
Ma'am, I don't know.
Okay, you can pass to other question to another one. Amna did not know it since. Okay, next.
I'll pass to Helen.
Helen, example of shrub. Lemon.
Yes, ma'am.
Correct. Okay. Next.
Ma'am, that is only the question.
Okay, Narendra. Okay, so congratulations, you tried hard. So when you come to the next chance, you have to do little more improve
okay,
your
ma'am.
Seminar by giving more pictures, and you should give some detail about what you are presenting. Okay,
okay,
Narendra. Yeah, Amna, I told someone to help you. You have to help someone. Who is that?
Ma'am, but Parvati.
Narendra.
Narendran over. Narendran is done. Anubhama helped Narendran.
Parvati.
Okay, Parvati did not come yet. Okay, so shall we now continue the class? Let her come, that time you can see. Did she send the PPT to you, Amna?
Ma'am, he told us, his cousin brother told how to share the board.
Okay. Ismail, did I give you any topic to conduct seminar?
Yes, ma'am.
Flowers. So flowers we can have after I complete the lesson. Okay, children. So what did we learn in the last class? Jaleen, what was the last topic we learned?
Ma'am, parts of flowers, petals and sepals.
Okay, shall we go back to here, all of you? So we just started studying out the flower. And what is flower? What is Jeline Elizabeth? What is a flower? I have told you one definition for the flower. What is that?
Reproductive part of a plant.
Okay. So flower is the reproductive part of the flower. Okay. What else the flower gives?
It's a reproductive part of a plant, right?
It is a reproductive part of the plant. At also, what does it give by looking at that color?
It gives the color.
Okay, why do the flowers are having the colors? Because flower wanted to attract the insects and butterflies. By looking at the colors, the butterflies, insects come to the flower and they will have the nectar. Why they want the insect to come to the flower? Because these insects will carry their reproduction to other places. Chrysanthemums and all that things, what they do know, the flower is having a one type of part where the new plants will come. So we are going to study that and all detail. So actually, flower is the reproductive part of the plant, and who helps the flower to produce new plant? It's the insects and butterflies. Okay, insects and butterflies will carry the egg from the flower. I can just say egg. Later you will understand why I am saying egg and all. Okay, so the flowers also have a small particle in which the new plant comes. So these butterflies and insects, they will come and they drink the nectar of the flowers. And while they fly from the flower, the eggs of the flower will be stick to their wings and stick to their thorns. And while they go to next flower, they will go and put that egg in other place. So then another plant will come. So this is how. Maybe breeze also does the same thing. We have learned in fifth standard, no, dispersal of seeds by animals, by human being, by wind,
by water.
Okay, and this is the reason, one of the main function for why the different flowers have different color, in order to attract the insects, birds, butterflies, dragonflies, to help them in reproduction. Okay, that is the why they are having a particular color. So shall we now go back to that?
Ma'am,
how many, anyone has brought the hibiscus flower? I told you to bring some of them, to bring the hibiscus flower in the class.
Ma'am, I have.
If you have a flower in home, bring.
Ma'am, I have that yellow color flower, ma'am.
Whichever color, hibiscus. Okay.
Ma'am, I have brought it, ma'am.
Okay, who is that?
Ma'am, Helen.
Okay, Helen. Okay, Helen. Someone is... okay, someone sent a message to me. Okay, fine.
Ma'am, I was in there the last class.
Okay. Okay, Helen, where is the flower? I will call you when it is needed. Okay. So, Helen, can you tell me three parts of the flower mainly?
Ma'am, petals.
Petals, okay.
Petals.
Sepals.
Stamen.
And stamen. Okay. So children, this is the slide. In the picture, you will able to see. These are the three parts of the major parts of the hibiscus flower. One is petals. Petals means where the broad color part, that is petals. And sepals, you will able to see the green type leaves, and these are the outer parts. Okay, these are known as outer parts of the plants. And I am also want to show you sepal. Can you See the sepal. If you zoom it, you are able to see me. I are having the sepals with me. Okay.
We cannot zoom it.
Yeah, you cannot zoom it. Okay. Anyway, this is the what you call for sepal. So sepal is the down part of the flower actually. Okay.
Sepal, ma'am.
Yeah. So Helen, you can also show that.
Ma'am, this is the sepal, ma'am.
Which one?
Ma'am, I showed, ma'am. Ma'am, this is a sepal. Ma'am.
Yeah, both of you show. Helen, show your sepals in the picture. Upside down. You keep the flower upside down. Upside down. And hold it little down. Little down. And can you touch and show under the hibiscus flower? You keep the flower little down. Down. You keep. So can you touch and show which is in the down part? Yeah.
Yeah. Ma'am, this is stamen.
Yeah, that is stamen. Okay, that is stamen. Yes.
This is petals.
Amna. Samna I also having. Yes, that is sepals. Okay, ma'am. I am also having the sepals in my hand. Yes.
Ma'am, Anupama is also having.
Okay.
Ma'am, cut the flower and inside like.
So all the flower is having all these things, okay? Sepals, petals and all. But depending upon the structure, it will change.
That one, every flower has?
Sepals, every flower has, but the size is different. Okay, each one size may be different.
Ma'am, stamen, every flower has.
Anupama, where is your flower?
Ma'am, this mean ma'am.
Okay, in that upside down you show, yeah, where is the sepals in that? Can you touch and show the sepals? Yes, you can see where the flower is. Yeah, Helen, yeah, okay, Helen, now everyone can see, clear, okay, yes, okay. Now what is the stamen?
Stamen,
yes, this is known as stamen, that thread one, and Anupama's flower also, that long thing which is in the middle, that is stamen. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
What type of flower it is, Anupama?
Ma'am, I don't know. My mother planted it.
Ma'am, nice, I think nice
it is saffron.
Okay. Okay, fine. Now there is one more part we are going to see, especially in the hibiscus. Helen, can you touch on the stamen? The last part, there are some red color dot things are there. The middle part, down. So that is known as anther, that reddish color in hibiscus. That is I told you bring the hibiscus. Amna's flower, I don't know where is the anther. It doesn't have. Okay. What about Anupama's? Anupama's? Is there any whitish thing on the top of it? Small particles? Ma'am, I cannot see. You have to
see two kind of two flowers. Amna's will have, ma'am. Amna's will have.
Amna's, you just see one dot. That is petal. Inside, that is another one. Okay. 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 So, that is I told you to bring the hibiscus. Yes. Yes. Okay.
I'm giving you hibiscus.
Okay. Okay. Okay, children. So, I think you are already know what you mean by the sepals and the... So, now everyone, those who have in your hand, keep it in your hand. As I explain each part, you can go through, you can check it by yourself. Okay. Okay, children. So these are the outer parts. Sepals. Everyone just check on it. All these are known as petals, sepals, and stamen. These are actually outer parts of the flower. But apart from this, you also will see so many other things. That is what we are going to see. And you can see in the down part of the end part of the stamen, in the hibiscus especially, you will see there is a reddish color, small things. There are so 2-3 branches, no? In the down part of it, end part of the stamen. And there are small red color things are there. So that is what we call anther. So anther is a part of a stamen. So I don't give you as important part is stamen and anther is the part of stamen. Okay. So three major outer parts are sepals, petals, stamen, and you also will see one another small particles at the end of the stamen. We call it anther. So anther is the part of a stamen. Now you are going to see in the stamen what are the things are there. Okay,
excuse me ma'am.
Did all of you write outer parts of the flower?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Did you write what is anther?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yeah. Next, no, we are moving. No. Okay.
Ma'am, we did not write about anther and we did not write about stamen.
Okay, anther is the part of a stamen. You can write anther is a part of a stamen.
Ma'am, we did not write about stamen.
Write all this, all these points, outer parts of a flower, or you can write outer parts of a hibiscus, petals, stamen, sepals. These are the three outer part, and anther is a part of stamen. Okay. And what is the function of the sepals? I want to give you, before I go to the inner part, I will give you the function of the petals, function of the sepals. Okay.
Ma'am, a sepal holds the flower.
Yes.
Ma'am,
I'll just give you now. You write. Did you write anything? Ma'am. Anything related to that, ma'am, in the last class?
Ma'am, we wrote petals, ma'am, and sepals.
Petals and sepals.
Sepals and petals.
But we didn't write what is the function of that. Okay.
Okay, yes, ma'am.
So first, petals. Petals. The function of the petals. It gives color.
Ma'am, that thing that we wrote.
You write? Okay. I think I have already. Oh, did I send you the notes for this chapter?
Yes, ma'am.
This I have written the function of petals. It gives color to the plants and attract insects. Attract insects for reproduction. So this is the function of petals.
The prominent part of a flower which give color.
That is the definition of what is petals. Now when you write the function of the petals, that is definition of the petals. Now which I have given, I think this is I have given in your notes, two function. One, it gives color to the plants, and also plants. Not more than plants, you can write flowers. That is better. Plant is different, no? It's a flowers. And attract insects for reproduction. That is the two functions of petals. It gives color to the flowers and attract insects for reproduction. Then sepals. Sepals protect. Or guard the buds to grow as a flower. Either buds should not fall down due to breeze or some of the things, the buds should not fall. So then only the flowers will bloom. So the function of the sepals is protect or guard the buds to grow as a flower. If you look at the buds, you will able to see the sepal very clearly.
Ma'am, when are you going to learn about stigma?
That is what the next section, that is inner part. That is so much, a lot of things are there. I am learning one by one, then only we can go to that one. Stigma, pistil, style, so many things are there.
Ma'am, in the notes you gave.
Yeah, already give. That is the last part of this chapter.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Okay, children. Now, what is the function of the stamen? That is what we are next thing. Stamen. Stamen, what do you call for stamen? It is the male reproductive. Stamen is the male reproductive part of a plant. Part of a plant. See, like human being also, we have male and female. So that is for the function of reproduction. Similarly, the flowers, the plants also have male and female. But some of the flowers, male and female are in one flower. But some others, male and female is different. So we call them unisexual flower and bisexual flower. Bisexual flower and unisexual flower. Unisexual flower means it may have both in one. Bisexual means it will be separated in the flowers. So that is the thing that you will be learning in the higher class. I don't go too much detail to that sexual flower and all, because that is coming in 7th standard. You have a reproduction in plants to learn. There you will learn about this male. But here stamen is known as male reproductive part of a plant. And we are now come to the parts of the stamen. That is how we are going to learn. So next heading you can write. After this, you can write parts of the stamen. Parts of the stamen. And mainly, there are two parts of stamen. The one part, what already I told you, anther. Yeah. Anther is the one part of the stamen. And another one is filament. Filament. So in your textbook, filament in cream color, but in the hibiscus, anther, anther is in red in color usually, but some of the hibiscus you can see the anther also in yellowish color also, depend upon the colors. Okay, so in the textbook it is given yellow color, so I am just writing that. But the hibiscus what I have, I also have a hibiscus, but it's anther, it's red in color. Helen, what is the color of a anther in your hibiscus?
Ma'am, red.
Red, yes. But some of the hibiscus and some of the other flowers you can see in yellow color.
Dylan has
ma'am, yellow color is white. It common?
Yes.
Ma'am, yellow color anther, is it common?
It's a part of stamen, yes.
Ma'am, is that color common or it is rare?
Cream color is for filament.
No, ma'am. Only anther, the yellow color is rare or common?
Okay.
Now we are moving on to the parts of it. This is the inside part of the hibiscus. So, Helen or someone, do you have the knife or this one?
Ma'am, can you show the previous slide?
Blade or something? Yes. I'll tell you what to do. Others just observe her, because only she is bringing that flower. Others flower you may not able to see. That's why. So Helen, you can open the stamen. Don't cut your thing. I'll just show you what I have done. I don't know whether you are able to see it or not. One minute. You just open the middle part of it.
Ma'am, like
from down. Keep it down. You keep it down, and I'll show you first. Let me remove from you then. One minute. Can you see me, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you see me, B? No, able to see?
We cannot see. You speak.
What is in my hand? Observe carefully. Actually, if you are in the class, I could have showed better. Now in the online section, what I have done means I opened this red color part of the stamen, and then you have to do gently. Otherwise, it will removed. Okay. I don't know whether you are able to see it. Helen, you have seen me. I have removed a thread-like structure in my hand from the flower. Anyone can see this?
Yes, ma'am.
Will you able to see me? Yes, what I am doing?
Two parts.
Yes, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
I'm telling you.
1 minute.
The blade, ma'am.
Remove the petals.
I'm telling you.
You will able to see. Remove the petals. And I cut open and you will able to see a thread-like structure here.
Yes, ma'am.
Will you able to see me, children? One yes, thread-like ma'am. Structure.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. We can see it.
Okay, I'm not able to hear you. Hello?
Yes, hello? Ma'am.
Hello, ma'am.
Okay, 1 minute. 1 minute. Can you see a narrow thread in my hand?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. So this is what we call filament. Okay. What I did means I cut open that red thing gently and we get a thread-like structure. So this is known as filament. Okay. Thread-like structure which is inside the stamen. And at the end, you will get the anther also. I got only one anther because it has been removed. I brought it in one plastic bag so that everything is gone. So I got only the filament now. Usually there is also is an anther. Okay. So now I can show. Jalin Shaiju, someone is having a hibiscus. Helen also.
Yes, Ben Jalin Shaiju, show he is cutting that.
Okay. Where is Helen? Gently cut. Don't cut your fingers. Helen, gently also. Okay. Yes. Yeah. Cut open that. Slowly. Helen, like that. Only top you cut and slowly use the finger and remove that stamen out of it. Okay. I think 2-3 petals you can remove, Jalin. You can remove 2-3 petals so that it is visible. Petals you remove and then you tear it so that this is visible for others.
Yes, he had network issue.
Okay. Children, anyway, others you can do at home and see this activity and you can see the filament in that. Okay. Now I separately taken anther also.
Ma'am?
Yes?
Ma'am, you gave us one activity to clean the garden.
Ah, yes. Did you do that?
I did it.
Okay. Very good. Send you the picture how well you cleaned, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Is it time up? Helen succeeded?
Yes, ma'am.
I'm telling you.
Yes, yes. You remove that, only that thread you take, other things you remove. Means don't remove the petals you remove, only petals remove, other everything keep it as it is. Remove the petals without the cutting that, okay? With the hand, remove the petals and you only show me that part, what you are. Okay, okay, don't remove. Okay, good, good. Okay. Yes. Yeah. Anther, don't remove like that. Let it keep it like that. Okay, keep it like that. That's enough. Don't remove the anther. Anther also should be on that filament. Slowly. Gently. Okay. Okay. Yes. Yeah. Slowly you do. Because this needed lot of patience. Otherwise, no, it will be cut, then you will not able to see. Yes. Yeah, yes. So she has kept on the finger that is filament. And end of that filament, there is anther. Since it is red in color, it is not visible. Okay? Okay. Now, take the sepal part. Jalin, take the sepal part. Sepal part. Yes. and remove the sepal gently. Remove the sepal gently. Inside part don't remove. Remove the sepal gently. I think her stuck. Helen, you are not succeeded. Yes. Yes. Okay. Okay. Yes. Children, this is the end of the stamen. You have another part. What Jalin Shaiju is showing, that is known as pistil. Okay. Pistil is the female part of the flower. So that end part, it is in sepal. That end part, what the Jalin Shaiju is showing.
Ma'am, inside there is stigma.
Inside is stigma. Okay. We are not come to that. Clear. So Agnes is not in this class, no?
No, ma'am. A section.
Okay. They are okay. Yes. Now, can you just cut open that pistil? I'll give you the notes later. You cut open that pistil down and middle part, Jalil. Gently inside there are some things. Don't cut that. Only opening cover you cut. Yes. Yeah. Gently you cut. Okay.
Ma'am, attendance.
Cut and open and show that inside there are some like a rice like a structure is there. That is what you call ovule. Ovule means where does the female plant, the small plant started growing. That is ovule. This ovule and yes. Jalin, can you raise it up and show little like that? You just raise it up your fingers little bit. Yeah. Okay, children. So this everyone can see little more. I think her net. Okay. You can see there is a small structure inside. It is just look like a small rhizomes in both sides, small rhizomes like structure that we call ovule. Okay, Jalin, thank you very much. Now it's time up. So I think you got an idea about the parts of a flower. Helen, you try and next class you can remove it and show me. Cut and remove it. Everyone, if you are able to do that in the next class, before my class, everyone take a flower, shoe flower, and then cut like that, and only show me that stamen with the pistil. Okay, together pistil, and so that you will learn the parts. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes. So what is pistil? Pistil is the female organ, and stamen is the male part. Clear? So next class we will detail about the stigma and all. So today how many present? Inovin. Inovin is in our class, no? Inovin. Ivanchal, where is Ivanchal?
He is absent, ma'am.
He's absent. Anubhama, Telsa, Tejas, Krishna absent. Okay.
Ivan, Shahar. Ma'am, at my home is the plant of hibiscus, but there is no flower.
Flowers. Okay, no problem. You can get it from neighborhood or something. Fine. Parvati, you joined late. So we could not have your seminar. Next class, we will have the seminar. Heard, Parvati? I saw you, but you joined late. Okay. Okay, children. Bye.